Wearing black with gold, official weight, 135 pounds. A perfect professional record consisting of 22 bouts, 22 victories, including 20 knockouts. From Toowoomba, Queensland, Australia, the undefeated WBO interim champion, the great Cassidy.
They're both world class. We'll find out who is the most world class tonight. One, it's scheduled for 12. The Colonel here with Dave Bontempo, straight right hand lead on HBO International.
And we see Katsinas immediately trying to throw the right hand lead for the effective style against the southpaw. Look for the double left hooks. Watch to see if he gets his lead foot outside, the lead foot of Amit Sato. He can operate in there. You know, there were many impressive things about Katsinas, but the one most unusual is that he had a 12-round victory in just his second pro fight.
Dave, watch the power of this guy. Now, Amit Sato can take a shot, but he's not going to hold up if he continues. See, he's walking right through the jab. Amit Sato's jab is not holding him up. I tell you, Katsinas is going to knock him out. There's no question in my mind watching it this early.
For Amit Sato, he could use this ring, move well. He doesn't have to settle for an inside battle. Let's see who imposes his will.
Well, you see who's imposing his will, folks. It's Katsinas.
I'm talking about for long term. Right now, It is Katsinas. We'll see if Amit Sato makes an adjustment. He's got perfect motivation after taking that right hand.
And another right hand. And he cannot allow this to go on. This kid's tough. And Katsinas, you know, all but his last fight were in Australia. So this is a big test for him. But the great, as he calls himself now, Katsinas, is a guy who will use the... Oh, he got caught with an uppercut, but he pounded right back with the right hand. Straight right hand again. He didn't like it when he got hit with that uppercut. The old days of the great warriors and Greeks. Oh, right hand got it and knocked him down. Flush on the jaw. Stuck the head.
Sing box. And Katsinas made him pay.
Oh, and he down into the right hand coming right in. Amundsen has to hang on. There's plenty of time here as Jane 80 separates the two and says, don't hold on. Catches him with the left hand this time. Hovers him with the right. The uppercut on the inside. Grabs the right hand of the jaw. Amundsen's in a heap of trouble. Look at this. He must get headbutted. There's a cut underneath the eye of Katsinas. He loads up the right hand. I told Katsinas I was in the locker room before, and I said, don't fool with this guy. I've seen him fight.
But look at that. We've got major problems here for Katsinas. And they're swelling under both eyes. You want to get close enough to really unload like what he's trying to do here.
Oh, look at it. He loads up the left hand that time. It gets the ball in the Philippines, hangs in there. He's making the mistake, too, of letting this guy come in on him. That right hand straight down the middle. But the Rock, or the great, as he calls himself now, takes an uppercut on the inside. Has Amit Sato done enough to win this round? No, not having enough punches. He's thrown a lot, and he's fought well, but Katsinas is just nailed with a power punch. Look at that! Whoa, how about that? The bell to get through. Right hand gets through. They both load up shots. It gets Katsinas back now. Closing seconds of the fourth round. Whoa, did he hit him with the old Mary Ann this time? And Amit Sato makes a statement at the end. This guy is terrific. And he's given Katsinas all Katsinas wants. Katsinas had Amit Sato down in the second round, but couldn't finish him off because of the condition. He caught him that time, Dave.
Well, you get on the ropes, sooner or later you'll pay for that. Amit Sato not jabbing, and he's just walking in. This is Katsinas' office now. He's defeated the office.
Yeah, the big left hand gets through. You try to land the uppercut on the inside, then the right hand. And Amit Sato, he's doing one whale of a job against his power-punching machine. From Toowoomba in Australia. Bang! He nails it again with a left hand that time. Katsinas having a great round.
Back to Katsinas. And Amit Sato needs to get back on the outside because he cannot match the power shots.
Nah, he's fighting in the wrong place. And he paid dearly for it in round six. But Katsinas
is Brendan Smith in line with Jeff Fennec and all the boys that get great fighters.
Look at this assault by Katsinas. He gets the seventh round going. He doesn't want the heads coming in. Straight right hand. He blasted him with that. Look at the combination by Katsinas. This is great stuff. If you're an Australian, you got to love this. Man, oh man, look at this stuff going.
What tremendous body punching to set up the shots to the head. Katsinas is a machine if he gets inside.
Plus, I'm explaining to you, ordinarily until we saw that headbutt sign come up, it all might be academic if Katsinas keeps blasting this guy in here.
to open up, so I suppose it was a headbutt that did it. But look at these shots now. The uppercut is there. Will you throw it? He doesn't. He goes to the body, though. And look at this guy. He just keeps taking shots. And he talks to Casillas. Casillas answers with a right hand. Big right hand. Blasts the head back. There's him again. And again. And throws him away.
Well, only one of those is a headbutt. That's the one on the top.
Headbutt is stopping it?
No.
It's not getting stopped yet. I want you just to breathe.
So that's as clear as I can make it for you, folks. But it's dangerous. Look at this kid battle back. He wants to end it now. He loads up everything, and Amosov's able to take it. Now he's hurt. Caught him with a good shot. He keeps on throwing. He's getting nailed. Bubble. He better answer, but Jay will stop it. He finally crumbles to the canvas. It's an accumulation of punches. Five, six, and six. Seven, you make the eight count all right.
What a whirlwind.
It's gut check time for everybody involved here. Casillas wants to end it. Jay won't let him take that score. He's not answering. That's about 20 unanswered punches. How much more punishment will Jay let him take before he stops the fight? Casillas is exhausted from throwing shots.
A lot of time left. He still has plenty of time to get this done.
But does he have any more power? Look at this kid trying to get his legs back going. He's heavy in the heels, loose in the knees. He's ready to go, but will he go? He's reeling around the ring. Casillas stays on top of him. It's still throwing. Casillas says, come on, you want to fight? Let's fight. Bang, he nails him. Bang, he's back. There's the bell to end the 10th round. This is a great prize fight. Two finely conditioned machines fighting for a world title.
The last
I get a 108 to 99 unofficially in favor of Casillas. So he can take one through the last round. If he's smart, he'll do that.
Protecting a lead because he's protecting his eye. That's the important thing for him here. You don't want some strange things to make this be the judgment of the referee.
Oh, he caught him again, David. Sorry, he caught him again. The kid from the Philippines is frustrated. The crowd might be a bit frustrated, but they shouldn't be. This has been nothing but a Pier 6 brawl. The bell is a terrific fight for both men. They wanted to hit each other after the bell. Then they realized once a little adrenaline slipped through their beautiful, magnificently conditioned bodies that no, the fight is over, and they hugged each other. Brilliant fight by both guys. Casillas' power overwhelmed Cesar Amonsad's heart and his superior speed.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the Mandalay Bay, we go to the scorecards. Ruben Garcia scores about 116-110. Patricia Morris Jarman, 114-112. CJ Ross, 115-111. All to the winner by unanimous decision. Still undefeated, the fighting pride of Queensland, Australia, Casillas the Great.